Today we're going to be doing an install on a Subaru Brumby. Okay, welcome back to Recarb. Today we're going to be doing an install on a Subaru Brumby.
This one's coming to us with major idle issues, so it won't actually idle. So we're going to rip the carb straight off and tune it from there. So what are you removing there, mate?
This is the fuel line. I'll get a clamp. You can probably do it with it in, but with it out, just gives you that much more room.
Or for activities.
Now, there is water under these carburetors. It is just a water up to the base of the carburetor, so it doesn't go through any passages. But because it is there, it does mean we need to be careful with regards to coolant pressure and coolant temperature.
Did you just hit your head?
Yes. Now ideally we want to do this when the engine's cold, so you've got no excess pressure in the system. As it is a little bit warm now, I'll just release some pressure and we should have that pulled off. I'll undo the other bolts first and come back to the front later. All going well, this should pull straight up.
That's the theory, isn't it, mate?
Should be a keyword there. The throttle cable is still connected. We'll just take that off the bracket. Woo! we recommend in all conversions that we should fit the carburetor with its bare necessities or no emission gear at all to start with. Just connect the carburetor with what's necessary to start the car, tune the car, get it idling properly. Once it's idling properly, you can then choose to connect emission hoses one by one. If the emission equipment is leaking or causing a problem, you'll be able to pick it up a lot easier. Subaru Brumby, the only connections that need to be on is the vacuum advance, as in the instructions. Now this can be connected either directly with a hose onto the vacuum canister straight onto the new carburetor, or you can still use the original plumbing from the car. If you just trace the pipe, you'll see that it ends up here and just can connect this pipe onto the vacuum advance of the new carb. That's the only small vacuum hose needed for connecting a Weber type carburetor. Otherwise, you simply need to connect the breeder to the air filter and you're finished. The instructions will simply tell you to block off any open vacuum hoses, this one and this one, job done.
Make sure to clean the manifold as clean as possible before fitting the Weber.
There's a water port in the manifold. Use some sealer on the gasket, Loctite 518. Again, is our preferred type. Instructions, it'll say to bend the vac spout out of the way, and this is the one here as it does foul on the front of the belt plate. That's simply achieved with a little bit of a
love tap, mate.
Just a little bit of a love tap, that's it.
Did you grab it by its love handle?
You buy your love handles?
Ooh, please later.
There we go. Now we can secure the plate down with the screws provided. Love to waste time, whiskey and wine, drinking all night, asleep by your side. Finally arrive, we would just drive, never arrive. Now with mounting plates, what we want to do is we want to make sure that the plate's all the way down. So what I'll do is I'll tighten the bolt and then I'll give the plate a wheel. It's all the way down. I'll loosen that back off and do that the same for the other three screws.
Why do you do that, Tom?
That just tells us that there's nothing under the plate that's going to hold it up, or that the screws themselves aren't actually bottoming out before they clamp the plate down. It's too late. Now I remember everything and how careless we. There you have it, your adapter plate is all installed. Now before we go any further with the installation, we're going to be pulling the factory throttle cable bracket off and doing some modifications to that.
That's what's so noisy.
Whilst we're still in the engine bay, we'll reroute the throttle cable as per our instruction manual. Essentially just to give us a little bit more. Like so. That just gives us that little bit of extra playroom. Now this can also be achieved with a big hammer. So what we want to do is identify which one of these is a fuel return, and that's easily done by it being the smaller of the two fuel hoses. So this one here, what we're going to do is trace it back, pull it back through, cut it off and block it.
What are we blocking it with, Tom?
We're going to just use one of the original studs we pulled out of the manifold. 6 mil, this is line is 6 mil. What you want to do is push it in far enough so we can clamp down on the flat section, because that's what's going to stop the fuel. Okay, as per our instructions, we need to refit this wheel and spring onto the Weber. Our Econ step up lever. And the throttle lever itself. Okay, with the rear wheel fitted onto the carburetor, you want to make sure it's not going to foul with any of the choke linkages. And in this case, it's quite smooth. Now, we are going to be connecting the AC step up, so we'll refit this one as well. Lock tab. Okay, we just want to get this lock tab and bend it over. Like so. The spring fitting from the screw here to the original spring mount on the wheel. Get in there. Like so. And it's ready to install.
This is sometimes a good opportunity to replace some of the factory clamps that have no longer got their tension. Thank you. make sure that the cable is slack at idle. If your bracket doesn't line up to the wheel, just bend it slightly. Next, fit your wiring harness.
In some models, this is going to be over here.
This is startup time, I think, right?
I believe we are all good for startup. Carburetor installed. Now it's time to just get the air filter on. Fit the base plate down with the gasket under it. The screws we use in this kit are too large to be able to fall down the throats. However, it's still good practice to put Loctite onto the screws, stop them vibrating loose. The breather in the corner is connected to the pipe we supply. That's your tapper cover breather. On the other side, the PVC. This is the original hose that you had off your factory carburetor's bowl vent, the fuel bowl vent. It's the right size, the right shape, and the right position. We'll reuse this. Just fit our breather onto the end. Connected onto the top of the PCV. Just sits between the top and bottom lid. Filter and breathers on. Carburetor fully installed, time to tune her up. So we can't tune the carburetor with a cold engine with the choke on. First thing to do is fire up the car and let it warm up. When you fire up the car for the first time, do look out for the danger signs. Just check for any fuel leaking, particularly on the fuel connectors, and check for any flooding. If you're unsure about flooding or how to fix it, give us a call, we'll get some help. Let it warm up until the choke's off. With the choke off, we just want to set the idle. Setting the idle, it's actually quite easy after you learn it for the first time. There are three methods. You can use a gas analyzer, a vacuum gauge, or just by ear. We're going to do the simple one today. We're just going to tune it by ear. The two screws you're going to need to find, idle speed screw. That's the one that just steps the speed up and down on the lever. The second screw is the idle mixture. That's the one right down at the very corner at an angle. The idle mixture screw is just like a tap. You screw it in to turn the fuel off or lower. You screw it out to turn the fuel on or richer. Tuning the car. Step one, just set the idle speed roughly to 800 revs. At about 800 revs, we then go to the mixture screw. Mixture screw, we simply turn it slowly in or out to achieve the highest idle. Listen to it by ear. That's picking up, so I'm going in the right direction. Okay, that's the highest idle I've got. So I'm going to turn it back now
and not lose any of that idle speed at all. Righto, that's the highest. We then just readjust the speed back down to 800 revs. And we're tuned. Alright, once it's tuned, we'll get you to just check one more thing. Set the timing, if you've got a timing light. Typically, Weber carburetors will respond better and flat spot less with extra timing. We've given this one an extra 6 degrees timing and left it at 12 degrees. The vacuum advance is very critical to run smooth on a Weber carburetor, a lot more so than the factory carb. To check the vacuum advance, just get a spare piece of vacuum hose, preferably clean. It on, we're just going to suck on it to apply vacuum. When we suck on it, we're expecting the idle to lift and hold. If I put my tongue on the hose, it should hold vacuum and not leak down. There we are, the vacuum advance works and it's holding. We can hear that the idle lifts and it's running cleaner. We let it go, back to idle. That's a good vacuum advance. If you're not getting a response like that, your vacuum advance could be faulty or collapsed, give us a call. We do stock them. We can supply one. Thanks.